What is up, everybody? It's Austin from P&W Bassin. Today we're gonna do something a little bit different, and if you guys cannot tell by the weather today, we're gonna be ice fishing. There's a lot of slush out here, guys. All right, guys, we are back here out at the pond. I've been trying to film for probably 3 days now, and I just haven't been able to get on some good fish, but I have a really good feeling today is the day. We're gonna be using like tiny little jig heads, and I do not have wax worms or anything like that, so I'm actually gonna be putting a night crawler on one of these jigs. Perfect, look at that juicy guy right there. That's what we're gonna be using today. I'm probably just gonna cut it in half. So that's the piece that we're gonna throw on that little jig that I have, and hopefully, some big old bass is gonna come up and munch it. All we're gonna do is take that little night crawler right there and pretty much thread it on this little jig hook. I have never seen anybody do this before, and I have never done it myself. So this is kind of like a new experiment. But I think if we jig this up and down, we're gonna get bit for sure. So let's test this out in the hole and get to fishing. We're getting bit, guys. We're gonna drop it all the way down to the bottom and probably take it off the bottom about 6 inches and kind of just play around with it to find out where these fish are. Got a fish. There we go, guys. There's the first bass of the day right there. Just a little guy. And I've noticed this pond has a lot of little fish like this, guys, and we're just gonna have to fight and get around it. I'm gonna set up two of these other poles in different holes that are nearby me and put a bell on them. So if they start ringing, I'm gonna run over there, catch the fish. And we're just gonna have to weed some of these little guys out until we find the bigger fish. There he goes. And before the video ends, I'm actually gonna show you guys a really secret tip that I use to catch so many fish while ice fishing. It really helps out a lot. So we're gonna throw them onto this little jig head, just like that. And we're gonna go over to a hole that is right over there. Bust through that hole. Drop it down there, let it sit by itself, and we're gonna catch a fish. There she comes. There we go, guys. Another fish, just like that. I can't even set up these poles without these fish coming and biting it. There you go, he found his way down. Just like that, guys. So we're gonna let that pole sit there, and we're gonna go over and try to catch a bigger fish on our jigging rod. There's a fish. Just another little guy. Come on, man. All right, guys, I just caught that one on just this little bit of worm. We're gonna try to get a bigger one down there. I know they're here. World record. Like, I'm surprised it's not bigger from spring.
I was about to say that.
Oh, he got a bluegill. So as you guys can see, we cannot get away from these little tiny fish like this. And this is probably the deepest hole we have right now. And I have my eye bobber with me, and pretty much I'm gonna use it today to try to find the deepest holes in this pond. And I'm thinking that the bigger fish are gonna be around the deeper water. I'm gonna come into my eye bobber app right here and see how deep this hole is. I'm pretty sure it's like 8 feet. Let me show the camera. It's got this freaking monster right here. This is what we're stuck catching all day. All right, holy cow.
How deep is it?
11 feet. So what I think we're gonna do is actually start cutting some holes in the ice further to the right, maybe a little bit further out. And I'm gonna just try to see if we can find a fish on the phone here and then try to catch it. So let's take this out. And like I said earlier, Washington doesn't have crap for ice fishing gear. And so we are stuck with using this axe today. Instead of using a normal auger, this is our tool of choice. So that hole is right there. I think I'm gonna come out here and see if we can get a little bit deeper water. All right, so now I'm gonna take the eye bobber, plop it right there in the middle. 9 feet here. What's cool about the eye bobber is you can also put on a flasher mode. So it's just like a normal traditional flasher. There's a few different modes you can go through. Saying about 9.5. Holy. Yeah. There's a freaking hole right here and I didn't even know it. My foot just went through it. Oh, dude, this is done by an auger. That's sketchy. My whole freaking leg just went in there. This one's 10.2 and that one's 9.5. Oh, we got fish here. Middle and on the bottom. So try dropping down there. All right, guys, so I actually just got done digging this hole right here and I fell into this hole. So Brandon's in here trying to catch a fish because I did get a few marks. You can see his lure right there, actually. You in mid column or bottom?
Bottom.
Okay, then maybe it was a fish.
Should I come up to mid?
Yeah, come up to mid. So we're gonna see if he can catch one of these fish.
Let's pause that video real quick, guys. I totally forgot to mention to you guys the photo of the day, and that is right here. This guy caught a 30-inch pike on the ice. I think that is absolutely amazing, and I am very jealous. Nice job, man. His username is right here. If you guys want to be featured in photo of the day like this on my YouTube channel, all you guys have to do is head to my Instagram account right here. And then once you have done that, just DM me your fishing pictures and I'd love to share them on my YouTube channel. Get to talk to you guys a little bit more. But other than that, let's get back to the video.
Somebody used an auger for that hole. That's the one I fell into. But oh, that was just a hit. Come on, come on. But anyway, I'm gonna try to catch a decent fish out of here. And if not, if we keep catching those smaller ones, we're just gonna go out deeper and see if we can find any bigger ones. Now it says this is 8.5, but it does say there's a fish on the bottom. Yeah. Oh, that's Brandon Jordan, I need your help.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna leave this here. Didn't get many bites, probably only two, but it's getting dark pretty fast, so I wanna keep digging some more holes. I'm gonna try to head out here a little bit deeper and see if we can get on some bigger fish. There we go, there's another. Still real small though. All right, guys, so it is starting to get a little late out here. It's starting to get a little dark. For some reason, every time I come out here, all I'm catching is those little fish. But I hope you guys liked my little tip for ice fishing using that little eye bobber. I think it really, really does come in handy when you're fishing, especially in these tiny little ponds. It would be nice to always have that, you know, super expensive fish finder that, you know, we all would want, but sometimes we can't afford stuff like that. And it's also really not realistic for me to have a ton of ice fishing here just because we rarely get this much ice here in Washington. So having this eye bobber works perfect for me. It's got that normal flasher mode, just like I showed you guys earlier. And eye bobber really does work. It helps you catch more fish. It helps you find the deepest parts of the pond, and that eye bobber will definitely pay off. But I am about to wrap things up here today. I hope I can come back out, make another video for you guys. I know there wasn't the biggest fish caught, but I hope you guys liked this little tip that I gave you. And now I want you guys to comment down below and let me know if you have ever used an eye bobber for ice fishing. How did it go for you? And if you haven't yet, give it a try, because I think it's definitely gonna pay off for you guys. But other than that, I just wanna say thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys have any other ice fishing ideas that you guys want me to do, maybe like a catch and cook on the ice, something like that, comment down below, let me know what you guys wanna see, and I'll see what I can do. I'm gonna stay out here a little bit longer and hopefully we catch a fish before it gets dark. But other than that, I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.